Welcome back to one more video session on algorithms using if statements or the decision control statements. In this particular algorithm, what we are going to do is we are going to find out the smallest of three numbers. Say for example, my numbers happen to be 5, 0 and 2. I should be saying that 0 is the smallest out of these three numbers. So before we actually go about developing the algorithm, let's first try to understand the problem and how are actually the mind or the human mind processes such a problem. So I would suggest look at this portion of the screen. So if you look here, what happens is you should be seeing the number 2. So if I ask you at this point, what is the smallest number? Without a hesitation, you will say that 2 is the smallest number. So in your mind somewhere, you have stored the smallest as 2. Now let us say I show you one other number. I show you the number minus 1. Now what your mind does is, the small in your mind is now replaced with minus 1. So 2 is replaced with minus 1 and minus 1 becomes the new small. Now after this, let us say I show you the third number. When I see the third number, my mind small decision does not change because minus 1 is still lesser than 0. So my small continues to remain minus 1. And if you ask me which is the smallest of these three numbers, without hesitation I will tell you that minus 1 is the smallest of these three numbers. Now using this particular thought process, let us try to go ahead and try to understand the problem a little bit and also develop the logic. So here what I am doing is, let us say I give the first variable name as A. Let us say it gives me the value 3. So at this point, the smallest number in my mind happens to be 3. So what I actually do is, I take a memory location called as small and I copy the value of A into small. So small is right now 3. Now let me move the paper a bit. Now when I see variable B, I see that the value of variable B, it contains minus 1. So what I do is I compare small, or I compare B with small. Now 3 is definitely bigger than minus 1. So minus 1 is smaller than 3. So my new small happens to be minus 1. So after this, I look at the variable C. Variable C happens to contain minus 3. So what I do is, I compare minus 1 which is in small with minus 3. So obviously minus 3 is lesser than minus 1. So my smallest of these three numbers happens to be C or minus 3. I am only interested to print this value minus 3 and not the name of the variable which contains the smallest value. So let's start with our logic. So the first part is, I have declared or defined three variables A, B, C and small. Since in step number 1, I have declared these variables and I have not given them any initial value of 0, I have put question mark at step 1 because they can contain some random or also called as garbage value in them. I am not sure what value they contain and I am not really bothered about it. Then let us say in the next step, I read the values of A, B and C. So A is 3, B is minus 1 and C is minus 3. Now if you remember, I have not seen these two at this point. I am assuming I have not seen these two at this point. So what I will do is, in the first step, I am simply going to assume that A happens to be the smallest. I am not going to look at B and C. I am simply making the assumption that A is the smallest. So at this point, A happens to be the smallest number. Alright. Now, what happens is, since I have only seen A, small is given the value of 3. Now, what I am going to do is, I am not going to process both at the same time. Computers can process only one thing at a time. So now I see B. So I compare B not with A, but I compare B with small. So in the next statement, I am comparing if B is less than small. If this condition happens to be true, is minus 1 less than 3, yes, this condition is true. So my new small value is going to be minus 1. So I have processed A, I have processed B. Now I am only left with the value of C. So what I am going to do in the fifth step is I am comparing the value of C with small. If C happens to be less than small, then my new small is going to be C. So here what happens is C is minus 3. Is minus 3 lesser than minus 1, which was the old value of small? It is true. So small is going to be C. And in the last step, I am simply going to write the smallest number is going to be minus 3. It is going to print. So whatever is in double quotes is going to print as it is. It's going to print minus 3 and then it's going to stop. As usual, we do not trust our logic without doing a testing or a dry run. So step number 1, all of these values are unknown to us. That's why I have put a question mark. Step number 2, let us say I read 3, minus 1 and minus 3. So A is 3, B is minus 1, C is minus 3 and I do not know what is contained in small. I don't care also. Now what I am doing is in step number 3, I am going to assume the value of A as the smallest. So small now becomes 3. Alright. Nothing has changed here. These fellows still remain the same. Alright. Now in step number 4, what I am doing is I am checking if this fellow B is lesser than this fellow small. So what happens is A doesn't change, B doesn't change, C doesn't change, but minus 1 is definitely less than 3. So my new small is going to become minus 1 in this particular step. Then I come to step number 5. When I come to step number 5, this is 3, this is minus 1. Now I am comparing this fellow C, minus 3 with minus 1. Definitely minus 3 is lesser than minus 1. So my new value of small will become C. So this small becomes minus 3. And now in the last step, when I print the message, it is going to print minus 3 as the smallest in this particular step. So I hope this gives you an understanding of how we find the smallest of 3 numbers. You can do a problem to find the smallest of 5 numbers or the largest of 6 numbers. The approach is going to remain the same. You're going to have step number 4, 5, 6, 7 or so on. There are other methods given on the web or in your books, but I find this method more sensible because if the number increases to say find the smallest of 7 numbers, 10 numbers, this method is much easier and more logical, and also that is exactly how your mind determines the smallest of 3 numbers. I am really converting my thought process into a series of steps so that if you see, if I follow these steps, I am going to get the desired